Magic 89.9.
The voice of summer.
Check it out.
Yeah. We got a website.
www.magic899.fm.
Check us out in cyberspace and enter a whole new dimension.
Magic899.fm. Mo, Mojo, and Grace Lee.
Now, earlier we said we were going to have Brian Gorel or Gorel. We'll ask him how do you actually pronounce the last name. He's calling in from Australia. Again, this is the guy that in the news, DJ Montano. And help me with the story here because, again, I'm not following as much as you are, Joe and Grace. But this is the guy that $70,000 was taken from him in some sort of, I don't know, like boyfriend on boyfriend, like what is this, like Second
Web
Life?
Web of Life.
Some kind of a scam of some sort.
Scam, scandal, where, in which like they were supposed to put up a restaurant, but there's a lot of drug use going on. It's all really nice because the people involved are the people we love to hate. So let's go ahead.
You know what? A lot of our...
Joseph, please.
What was that?
A lot of our listeners have been...
Quiet.
You and your boyfriend, do your little...
A lot of people have been following this. You know, even before we got onto the newspapers, even though before we got into TV, I know we talked about it on our show.
Yes,
so
we did.
It's finally come full circle. So, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Brian Gorel.
Hey, Brian. Good morning, buddy.
Hi. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hi, Brian. Good morning.
Good
morning. Thank you very much for having me on.
Yeah, Brian, you're quite the celebrity now these days around here.
Yeah, you are.
But still, you got screwed. So I want to talk about what happened.
I did get screwed. And not the good times either.
Yeah, that's a good kind of screwing. At least initially.
Yeah.
So, Brian, you're in Australia. So I guess everybody knows that.
Yeah.
And you got is it $60,000 or $70,000 US?
No, I was thinking $70,000 all up. That's the amount that I've lost.
Mm-hmm. I think you got to share the story, like, in a nutshell, at least for those listeners that don't know about it yet.
Right, because I didn't follow it as much, because, let me tell you honest, I know that some of them might be your friends, and I'm not really a big fan of high society. Don't like people who party over their family wealth, things like that. When I see something like this happen, I actually get excited. And not for you, in a sense where you got screwed, but more like when I see high side people go down, this is great for me. It's so entertaining. That's why I'm so excited to talk to you. So what happened? What happened to you?
Well, in a nutshell, I'll make it as brief as I can. I came to the Philippines last year for a holiday with my best girlfriend, who's a Filipina, lives in Canada. We went to the peninsula for a few days prior to a Boracay holiday, and that's where I met DJ. He was working on a photo shoot for his newspaper.
Now, who is DJ Montano? Because I don't know this guy. Apparently, Mojo, you know him.
That's the name of the blog here, and
What does he do? Is he like just
a part? He's a social fixture.
He's not a DJ. Just because his name is DJ.
No, he's not a DJ. His name is Adelfin Justiniano Ocampo Montano II.
Oh, okay.
It's a long name.
Wow, that's a long.
I thought it was related to DJ Mo.
Question.
If I had a name like that, I'd roll with DJ too. All right. All right. Anyway, go ahead.
So, we met, and I admit it, was a whirlwind romance. We both ended up on Boracay.
Mm-hmm.
He had previous plans there to do some events, and that's where the relationship started. And I was in a situation on the island where I was very much in a hedonistic environment in terms of being a tropical island and so on and so forth. And
hold on, one second. Grace, you know what hedonistic is?
I got swept up. I was swept up.
Yeah, it was.
You were swept off your feet, like talented Mr. Ripley.
I was pretty much swept off my feet. For the simple reason is, I come from a very tiny town in Australia.
I saw your house, by the way, there. I'm so...
Yeah.
He was
it
featured,
used to be my house.
Yeah, it used to be his house. He was featured on TV Patrol last night, and the money that he used that was supposedly swindled came from your house. You had this beautiful house.
I did. Well, what happened was, when I came back to Australia after my Boracay holiday, I had decided to move to the Philippines to be with DJ, and...
Oh, no.
Yeah, well, it all happened very quickly. Looking back on it now, obviously, I feel incredibly foolish, but that's here nor there. I've stopped kicking myself in the gut.
Yeah, but if you don't mind, Brian, I mean, $60,000, yes, a lot of money. $70,000, yes, a lot of money, and I know you need that. But
yeah.
if it was me, I mean, $70,000 is, I'd be willing to lose that just to know the truth about who I might be spending the next, like, 30 years of my life with. You know what I mean? If you want to take the positive out of it.
Oh, no, look, there's been a whole list of positives that I've extrapolated from this experience. There's no question about that. But I've been through other things in my life where I've also had to step up to the plate and take control of the situation.
Right.
Well, so it's something I'm familiar with.
How did you lose the money? That's what a lot of people are probably want to know right now that are hearing this for
the
first time.
Well, I lost the money. It's quite simple. When I came home, I stayed here for 6 months, and DJ put me on a payment schedule for our businesses because when I came back to the Philippines, I wanted something about to be launched for various reasons. Mm-hmm. I needed an income stream. I thought it would help me with my immigration if I did in fact decide to migrate.
What about business?
It's all very connected, as you know there.
Right.
So I sent him Western Union $7,000 a month.
Wow.
And it is a lot of money now that I have none left.
Right.
But at the time, I saw this as an opportunity to parlay it into my future, pretty much. And that's exactly what I did.
Old Twister and Mojo Jojo with Grace Lee.
Hey. More music. Time to drop some more.
Thou shall not steal.